Just to let you guys know, like we always say, all the stuff you see us do is real. It's not premeditated. We actually make contact. Absolutely. He clocked me several times in here. But there's a lot of people who had questions about the validity of my gun disarm. They'll say people who haven't seen it and haven't experienced it will think that it's lacking speed and power and whatnot. We just spontaneously pulled that off just now. And I just wanted to, you know, have Phil, you know, you know, share with you his thoughts and feelings about what the technique actually felt like.
Yeah. Make sure that you guys are aware that, first of all, my man's techniques are real. None of these are movie flashy BS, any flossy things like that. When he put the lock on me, you want to drop the gun before he even applies the pressure. It would definitely scare someone who was unable to quickly apply any kind of a
counter or anything?
Yeah, or counter, or if they were a random person with a random gun doing a random act of violence, this technique would definitely deal with them. I was expecting it, and I didn't know when to expect it. I knew that's what we were drilling, but I had no idea that the drill was that real. So you guys, again, like I always say, go out, practice the technique, and the proof is in the pudding.
Excellent. Well said. Well said. And I want to piggyback off of that idea you just said. When we drill live and we drill concepts. So when you hear us talk about height, width, and depth manipulation, you know, gun disarms and things of this nature, we're not doing a demo. We're actually drilling against actual resistance.
Absolutely.
You know, I have sweat on here. He's knocked some sweat off of me in the face.
Yeah.
Need me all in my mouth. Inside my lip is busted. You know, but that's the way you train. You're not going to get hurt, not seriously, but you will get invaluable information, invaluable technical skill, invaluable experience. You know, the cartwheel escape that you saw me do, that was a real escape. And it was spontaneous.
It was hurt not like hell.
Yes, yes, yes. And getting kneed by him, it was no fun. He really did slam my head against the wall. All the stuff you saw, that was for real. Okay? And the point I'm driving home here is that every facet and every aspect of capoeira is legitimate. Unfortunately, the majority of individuals train what we refer to as cardio capoeira, which is really fun, really social, acrobatic, it's beautiful, it's aesthetic, it's musical, and all of that is part of what we do. But unfortunately, they skip all of the stuff you just saw, the real deal, self-defense, technical skills from which all refinement, from which all culture, from which all spirituality, from which all personal development comes from. Because if you're too busy being dead because your self-defense skills failed, you will not be able to develop yourself spiritually or anything else because you're dead. All right? Remember also, our ancestors created capoeira or kipura, or as the Portuguese call it, capoeira, you know, as a genuine, comprehensive, holistic vehicle of self-defense, personal, and spiritual holistic evolution and development. Okay? If you're missing any part of that pie, any part of that comprehensive circle, any part of that synergistic effect, that whole, you're not practicing capoeira. You're practicing something else. If you practice only the fighting, you're practicing self-defense. If you're practicing only the exercise aspects and the fun, that's all you're practicing. You're practicing cardio capoeira. We do the whole thing, which is why I connect the orishas to it, which is why I'm at pains in my blog, you know, capoeira that works, to point out to you the historical roots of this. And also why I'm at pains to show you our acrobatic skills are advanced. All of these moves that you saw us do, we can actually do in a hold up. All of us can and have done so. And I've done it also against other martial artists of other styles. You should never, ever, ever be in a position where you think that your techniques can only work in the hold or only work against other capoeiristas. You can either do it or you can't. If you can, then you're doing capoeira. If you can't, then you're not. What's up? Okay? All right, you ready to know what to do? Leave your name and any questions you have at the end of this video. Okay, I'll be more than happy to respond. My email is taxjimcapoeira@gmail.com. That's taxjimcapoeira@gmail.com. You can see it right there on the screen. Helping me out is my cousin and assistant coach, Phil. Behind the camera is Tati. And again, thank you very much for your time. Ashe capoeira.